Dayton celebrates a very special anniversary, so we sent our resident kid to take a closer look back at 30 years of fun. Here's Mike Randall.
A handful of investors broke ground in October 1960 for what was then Western New York's first and only amusement park. Everyone was excited about Fantasy Island. Pat Nesbitt was. She started working there at the age of 14, and she's been having fun, wow, ever since.
It's very hectic. It is very hectic, but I really enjoy it. Fun, wow.
Poring over hundreds of photos and news clippings, Pat's been officially voted the park archivist. It was plain to see that in 30 years, one thing hasn't changed at Fantasy Island: the smiles on the kids' faces. Another thing that's been around since the beginning, Western Town. Yeah, there's a lot of good memories here in Western Town. Well, from my childhood, I can remember Buckskin Joe, Marshall Rick, Calamity Jane, a lot of folks here at the Golden Nugget Saloon.
Hey, TV guy, what you doing in my town?
Oh, I forgot about Black Bart. You know, we figured out that in the last 30 years, Black Bart has been shot over 10,000 times. But he always gets up. And speaking of big stars, whatever happened to resident lion tamer Tarzan Zerbini?
Tarzan Zerbini, believe it or not, is still performing in Florida.
So here's to 30 years of memories and 30 years of fun, Fantasy Island. And may you have many more. On Grand Island, Mike Randall, Eyewitness News.